send this video to a worthless, dumb SJW the next time that they call you a racist when you simply say that black people can be racist and or that white people experience racism. Now, I've made videos in the past explaining before that everyone can be racist and everyone can face racism, primarily in my video called White People Are Under Attack. You can check out that video at the end. But the point is, black people can be racist, and white people can face racism, and also SJWs don't even know what racism means. So, the definition of racism to an SJW is having white skin automatically makes you racist, and black people being black automatically means that they face it. That's what racism is to an SJW. But if you actually read the fucking dictionary, not the modern one that was changed by SJWs, but a real dictionary that you find in a library, it will tell you that racism is simply the act of hating a person based on skin color. That's it. Okay? And merely making a statement like white people experience it and black people can dish it out is not a racist thing. It's simply saying that we face it or can dish it out. It's not saying that we merely hate those people. I have also heard people being like, oh, you're a racist if you simply point out that you have a friend who is a person of color. That's not racist for two reasons. Number one, you can't be racist to a black person if you have black friends. And secondly, you're not racist just for pointing out a person's skin color. Again, racism is the hatred of another person based on skin color. If I simply said, hey, I have an Indian friend, I'm not being racist to Indian people. I'm merely pointing out I have a friend who is Middle Eastern. That's it. But in our culture today, you are considered racist just for pointing out a person's skin color. Not if you like it or dislike it, but if you just say it, you're considered racist. But for all the stupid SJWs, let's talk about their point of view. In their point of view, the reason why black people can't be racist is because they believe that racism is not about hatred, but rather about natural power. Yes, this is actually what they think. So basically what they think is that because white people in the past had more power than black people due to, you know, black people's oppression hundreds of years ago, they believe that a black person is incapable of being racist because they have less power than white people. Well, side note, they used to, they don't anymore. But the point is, black people used to have less power than white people, so to an SJW, a black person is unable to be racist. And on the flip side, they believe that a white person is incapable of not being racist because they have more power. And since they believe racism is based on power, they believe that all whites are racist because all whites, in their mind, have more power. But not only is this wrong based on simply the actual dictionary definition, but it's also wrong based on the statement itself. Let me explain something to you. You are saying that black people inherently have less power simply because their skin color is black. This statement is racist. You are assuming that a black person can't have power because their skin is black. This is a racist thing to say to black people. You are saying that no black person can have power. It is incapable of them to have power, to be strong, to be tough, to be rich, to be famous, just because they're black. You are being racist to black people by saying that they are incapable of being above anybody, or being rich, or growing in society because they're always being held down. You saying that is what's keeping black people down, assuming they are being kept down, but they're not. But assuming they are, it would be the cause of SJWs saying that they are. And on the flip side, it's also being racist to white people, but the fact of the matter is, you are being racist to black people when you say that they are being kept down simply because they're black.
Hey guys, fast forward to the brand new Matt's FTR channel. I actually have to add on a new segment to this video, the true meaning of racism. Because of what's happened to me the last few days with a bunch of people actually accusing me of being a racist just because I read the word N-I-G-G-A, I'm not going to say it again, but I will spell out what the word was. This video is not going to be about what happened, but it is in reference to it. I recently learned, especially after this whole ordeal happened, by talking to a lot of people of different ages, It turns out that this belief that NIGGA is racist is actually a modern thing. It's basically an SJW belief. And I didn't know that, because up until a few days ago, I literally had no idea that people could not say NIGGA. But to be honest, I still believe we can, and I'll explain, you know, the past and the present. Here's the thing. The meaning of racism is discrimination and prejudice of somebody based on their skin color. Which means if you use a racist term, it's only actually racist if you say it to the person of who that insult is, like, geared towards, right? Like NIGGA or NIGGER are racist slurs for black people, but they are only racist if you are saying it to a black person. If I say those words based on reading it in a book or reading a message out loud, which is what I did, or let's say singing it in a rap song, something like that, it's not racist because you have no ill intent behind it. Simply saying the word out of the blue or to a friend means nothing. Imagine if I'm telling a racist joke to a friend and the other friend is white. So I'm white and the friend is white. No racism because we're just two white people talking. But what if that white friend records it and then plays it on the internet? You're going to say it's racist because other people are now hearing it. But it doesn't change the fact that I only said it to another white person. So there's no racism there. There's no ill intent there. The truth is, it's only an SJW belief that NIGGA is racist, because it's not. I'm 31. I'm of an older adult generation. And no more than just a few years ago, black people believed that NIGGA was basically the safe way of saying NIGGER. And they considered it to be a term of endearment and would even allow their white friends to say it. I literally have black friends and they let me say it, or are okay if I do, because they consider NIGGA to be a term of endearment. And I believe the only people who are not okay with it are young people who are also SJWs, because they don't understand the way things used to be. And you would think that when I say used to be, I'm talking like 20 years ago, but I'm not. I'm talking no more than like 5 years ago, basically before the SJW culture started. That's how I realized that this belief is not a real belief. It's just something that SJWs believe in. I personally, this is my personal view now, and I've said this before in past videos, I don't believe that NIGGA is okay. Why? Because I don't believe that simply changing a letter makes the definition change. Just like how I don't think that black people should say it either. They think they can because the word was used against them. But I personally don't believe that you can change the definition of a word based on the skin color of the person saying it. I believe the word is bad across the board, and I also believe that the ER version and the A version are the same thing because it's only a one-letter change. But this isn't about me. This is about the people who are getting angry, and those people believe it's not okay. So you are the ones who are hypocrites here. The exact same people who are telling me that it's not okay are the exact same people who would say it themselves because they themselves are black, and for some reason genuinely believe that just because you yourself are black, it means that you can change the definition of a word. No. Whether if you're black, white, or brown, the word N-I-G-G-E-R, or the A version, are still bad words. They're not all of a sudden good words just because you're black. It doesn't work that way. You can't just change the fucking definition because you feel like it. At least you shouldn't be. But here's the most important part. Racism is about attacking somebody based on their skin color. So if I'm not saying the word directly to them, I'm not actually being racist. At most, I'm just saying a word that's bad that I shouldn't be, but I'm not being racist. There's a difference between just simply saying a bad word and actually implying racism behind that word. It might be bad to say, but I'm certainly not racist for doing so. You cannot call racism because somebody sang it in a rap song or read it in a book. That is completely unfair to that person. Remember last year, or I think it might have been the year before, when PewDiePie actually said N-I-G-G-E-R? But here's the thing, if you recall what happened. He was being slandered for that, yet he only said it while playing a video game. Yes, he was live streaming and a lot of people heard him say it, but he wasn't saying it to his stream, he wasn't saying it to a black person, he was saying it to a video game character. Sure, the word is bad and he shouldn't have said it in general, but to imply that he's racist, despite the fact that he was talking to a video game character, is fucking stupid. Sometimes people yell at video games. It's actually a pretty common thing to do. So the point remains. It might be bad, but it's not racist. And here's the most important point I want to leave you with. This point is for all the young people who believe that it's racist, even if you just read it, and believe that the NIGGA version is racist. If you believe that, pay attention to this last segment. If you are the kind of person to be bothered by this word in every single capacity, even if it's read in a book, even if it's sang in a rap song, and even if it's the NIGGA version, the real problem here becomes you. Because what you're doing by being bothered by it in every capacity is you're just giving the word more power. You are deliberately making the word more powerful by being bothered by it, even if it's just read in a book. The whole goal here should be for the word to lose its meaning and its power. And it's never going to lose its meaning or power if you keep being bothered by it, even if you see it in a book or a video game or in a rap song. That's the real truth here. If you truly want this word to lose its meaning and its power, then you should only be calling it out if somebody actually says it to another person, and not in some kind of a stupid, safe way, like reading it, singing it, or saying it in a video game. It becomes your problem then. That's the real truth.